Before we get to that Doppler, I want to show you what we're seeing right now on our SkyCam network across the state. We have these water-loaded clouds, even a little bit of blue in between some of these clouds. But in order to see the thunderstorms form, we need a little bit of a lifting mechanism. We have plenty of humidity, plenty of moisture. That's not a problem. It's that lifting mechanism. With the heating of the day, we expect to get that engine moving, and then thunderstorms start ringing out in the atmosphere around 12, maybe even 1 o'clock in the afternoon. This is our WVTM 13 live Doppler right now. This is all real-time information. Sometimes a sweep goes through in a minute and we see a shower just popping up. There have been a few spotty showers on our WVTM 13 live Doppler this morning, but it's mainly been located in areas right around Fort Payne, Gadsden. But check this out. This is the visible satellite view. You can see there is some cloud cover and humidity coming in from the Peach State, but it's mixing with the already saturated atmosphere that we're stuck with. There's an area of low pressure that is just hammering areas of the Big Bend region with rain. And I'm mentioning this low pressure center because it will be one of the moisture sources that will aid in our coverage as far as rain goes over the next couple of days. It's going to shift more towards the west, and that's going to increase our scattered coverage in areas like Tuscaloosa and Bibb counties. 80 degrees right now in Birmingham, 83 in Tuscaloosa right now, but it feels like 88 degrees. It's 9:18 in the morning, and it's getting close to feeling like 90 in Tuscaloosa. If you're heading out today around the Black Warrior River, just keep in mind the umbrella. It's good for, of course, raindrops, but also for a little bit of shade. Just putting one layer in between you and the rays of the sun helps a bit. Sneak peek into your Independence Day forecast. By midday, temperatures will be in the 90s. We do have scattered thunderstorms expected on Wednesday, which is July 4th, but most of them will fizzle out shortly after the evening hours. Right now, we do see that the temperatures will be in the upper 80s on Monday, and that's basically because the cloud cover that we're seeing right now, we expect that to hang around, and the scattered thunderstorms in the afternoon look a lot more widespread on Monday. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, that summertime pattern, it sets back up all the way into early next weekend.